The convention basically.
That was what they were set out to do in the first place, an elective convention.
No, I'm not denying that. And that was why I said that even Senator Alimodu Sheriff participated, hoping that there will not be election into his own office, until it was clear to him that there will be. But what we are saying is that the convention could also be non-elective, and that actually happened. So it okay. is not, it is, we have not breached the law in any way. Rather, I don't know whether I can just quickly add this. You see, all that is happening now is very political, and democracy is really threatened now. Now, in 1983, after we had democracy instituted after the 79 election, 1983, we had a coup that put us back maybe over 20 years. Now, we are fortunate that probably the participants there, some of them are also now in government. We are having a similar, because there is no reason why the convention of PDP should be seen. Even Justice Abang, let me be fair to Justice Abang. Justice Abang did not say that the police should go and see. Justice Abang said that the police should not participate, because there was already
we'll look at that.
Saying that we should participate.
We should, we'll look at that hopefully. Okay. But let's get Markwa in. She likes to put in the question as well. Markwa.
I think that he's beginning to approach, you know, some of the areas where I'm interested in. I mean, he's talking about the judiciary's involvement now, but looking away from that and looking at the convention itself, there's been the politics in Lagos in terms of what's been happening. If the convention was going to have been elective, you know, there were some politics that were, you know, brewing already in Lagos. And how was Lagos able to resolve that, you know, before the convention eventually held? Or is it still simmering in, somewhere in the background?
Thank you, but for the sake of explaining this, let me admit that yes, we had these lingering issues and the discord, I mean, in the making of the ESCO. But you see, the interesting thing is that before now, I think about 10 days ago, in furtherance of the reconciliatory move by the Jerry Ghana committee, which the Southwest leaders now, I mean, brought to Lagos, and other states from the Southwest also joined us in Lagos. We had an agreement where, for Lagos State, let me tell you, it was agreed, to the best of my knowledge, that it should be 60-40. So even those who were in support of Senator Alimodu Sheriff, I mean, you saw Senator Kashamu there, you saw our own people in Lagos also there, they all agreed at that meeting that, okay, for the sake of this convention, and that let us have peace now. We all agree that 60-40. 60-40 is what we have on paper now. Is what would have reflected had the convention held yesterday. So there is no reason for anybody to come so deep into the internal issues of the PDP. And that is why we are not happy that the government is directly involved. I just said that Justice Abang did not say the police should go and seal. Justice Abang said that the police should not participate, because we already had an order. We said the police, the INEC, and other relevant agencies should participate. So it was another order by Justice Abang. We said the police should not participate. And he, supposing the Justice Abang even said that the police should participate, should it not mean that the police should come and seal?
How were they to have enforced the ruling?
Justice Abang was also clear when he also suggested to the claimants in that suit that they should prepare to go and bring up forms 47 and 48. These two forms are what you need. You don't need, what they have done now is self-help by proxy. They have used the state apparatus to now
to prevent
overpower
from
the PDP.
Is that because to prevent it from 48?
Why are they in court in the first place if they cannot continue the legal proceedings? The claimants acting for APC. What they ought to do? I mean, was to go and take up take out forms 47 and 48, which is ordinarily a contempt proceedings, because this is law now. It means that the court says you should not do something or do something, and you neglect deliberately. You understand? Then the court can take you up, and all they need to do in this era is just go and view. Take your own personal camera. View. You don't even need all everybody. You don't need somebody like me. Just take 1, 2, 3 people. You understand? And then, but rather, the states now descended into the politics of PDP because they want to kill opposition.
Just give us a moment. If the police had not done what it did, don't you think that from, is it 408, would have applied?
What?
The form that the Justice Abang was talking about. Don't you think it would have applied if the police didn't act the way they did?
No. The police actually went for an overkill because, like I said, there's no reason why they should go and use such full force. Because if not that the leadership of the party advised some of our own youth against going to confront the police, you understand? I will have, River State is
Let me reframe that. Let me rephrase that.
Okay.
If you had gone ahead and held the convention,
yes,
wouldn't that have been in outright contempt of Justice Abang's ruling?
Legally speaking, it may be. You understand? It may be. You understand? Because we need to go to court. Contempt is not automatic. You will still need to purge yourself, you understand, of whether you actually went against the order of court or not. But let me tell you, politically, I am more interested in the political issues now because all these legal thing is driven by the political undertow, and that is why I even want to beg Senator Alimodu Sheriff.
Since you're talking about
he should leave this toggle of being tagged.
Is all this infighting in the PDP, all this desire to kill yourselves, is it to serve Nigerians, to serve this country, or is it for yourself and grandizement?
Let me clarify that. The PDP has showed enough that it is one party that no matter the level of discord, they won't kill themselves. And they cannot. And that is why we want the whole nation, we want
cases.
The world to know that it is even the states now.
With 15 cases in court. No, wait, hold on. With 15 cases in court, you won't kill yourself. Is it the states that is
okay,
taking
up
the case?
Where do you want us to go? You want us to go before the shrine or to start killing ourselves? It's only the court that we can go. That shows that we are a decent party.
I thought you were a family. You could settle yourselves inside.
We are settling it. You understand? We are settling it. And all this thing is just deliberate. It's a distraction. We have the party issue. We have so many areas of misgovernance in the country. Then the state is deliberately coming so that there can be distraction. People will think that it is only the PDP that is the issue in this country. See, we are begging General Buhari to please allow opposition.
President Buhari.
To please allow opposition. The opposition that is critical today can be very constructive and help your government tomorrow. But the manner the whole thing is going about, it shows that they want to kill PDP completely because PDP has only put a threat politically come 2019. And so our own fifth columnist, who are also in the party, should also, try to shed off this toga of betrayal. They should stop it.
All right. Well, thank you for coming on, Taufik Ghani, the publicity secretary of the People's Democratic Party in Lagos. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Thank you.
Well, there you go. And that's the show today. We thank you all for watching. We'll see you next time. I'm Chamberlain Oso.
Thank you for watching. I'm Neo Taigwe.
Although I wasn't clear on what the 60-40 arrangement meant, but hey, we will definitely stay on the matter. Thank you so much.
Yes.
See you next time.